Hello and welcome to another Skylotec Masterclass video here at REAX. Last time we brought you the Skylotec ICX video. I think we're going to put a link to the top left here. To the right, I've got the infamous Bob Murdock, the technical sales advisor for Skylotec. So, Bob, I can see you brought something new today.
Yeah, hi Tom. So, the ICX, the newest power ascender from the Skylotec Actsafe range of products, was launched a little while ago at the show.
Yeah.
We've been busy beavering away and making as many as we have. Mm-hmm. So they'll start to hit the UK market very soon. But it's a much different beast from the ACX. You can see the size and weight. This one's much smaller. So out of the box, gives you an idea of the difference in the size there.
Yeah, massively. So I can see a couple of similar features.
Yeah. But well, we've got the same colour coding.
Yeah,
we've got emergency stops on it. We've got a throttle on it. We use the same carabiner on an attachment sling. But there are quite a few differences to it. First one, quite a noticeable one, it's rated for one person.
Okay.
So the machinery directive gets updated. There are some EN norms within that that we use for testing the relevant parts. So it's harmonised from a few different standards. And under the machinery directive, this has been certified as one person.
Okay.
You can have rescue procedures with this because we still have a remote control. We can still rig at the bottom or rig from the top and lower remotely. So there's still lots of ways to do it. But we won't do a two-person pick-off. Okay. If that's what you wanted, then you would take the bigger and more powerful ACX. Yep. Yeah. So this is a Husqvarna BLI 200.
Okay.
So this is a standard off-the-shelf battery from the Husqvarna range. So you could buy extra batteries wherever you want.
Okay.
Or if you're the kind of business that works internationally, you could fly with your equipment without the batteries, so you avoid dangerous goods and expensive air freights.
Yep.
Just put it in as a normal piece of work equipment and just buy a battery when you get there.
Okay, useful.
So there are some big advantages. Yeah. The battery technology is really good. We have a remote control that goes with it. In the box, if you buy a standard box with one battery, you also get your charger and your leads for charging both the battery and the remote control. There's always a sheet for your pre-use inspection, and there'll be a user manual as well, which is just on my desk at the moment because I need to read it.
Okay, brilliant. So we'll get on to that probably in a second then.
Yeah.
So let's just maybe just have a run through some of the key differences which have been developed when this is launched.
So let's turn around and have a quick look. We do a pre-use inspection, so we check our battery terminals, check our battery, make sure nothing's broken.
Mm-hmm.
We've still got the power indicator,
okay,
so we can see it's fully charged. When it goes in, it has a double latch, so that's in, but it won't come out now.
Yeah.
I have to push it down firmly, and it will click in. It's now fully located. So you can't drop it. You can't accidentally open it. If you have to open it, you have to pull both sides. I just reach underneath and give it a little push up, but then it's still latched in. So it's a double button and then a double stop to get it out, to take it out completely.
Okay.
So we make sure our E-stop's out and then we can turn it on. All the lights light up. It's all explained on your user guide, all your different light codes. It's far more information feedback from this machine, far more advanced in its management systems than the ACX, because it's a newer machine. Now, it has a completely different rope loading mechanism as well.
Okay.
So if we do all our inspections, I'll just turn her off again and open the rope guard. Now, that has a double switch on top, so again, a double mechanism to open.
Yeah.
I can see my rope wheel. I can see the tooth to make sure that the rope's ejected. I've got a roller on either side as a rope guide when the rope goes out. And on the bottom, I can see my rope guide here, which is also on your pre-use check.
Yep.
So you can check your wear indicators and make sure that's fine. I have a rigging point here, which is just 100 newtons.
Okay.
And that's purely for if we bottom rig it, to make sure that it's held safe and it's not spending its time bouncing off the ground as the load comes on and off.
Yeah, brilliant. Which is what we did with the, well, what we've done with the ACX quite regularly, isn't it? One of the key things that stood out to me was obviously we had, last time we had the sort of twisting handle to operate it, and now
that's
slight change there as well.
So we'll go through, and when we're on the ropes, we'll show how we load the rope, how it goes through. When you close the gate, push it down firmly, make sure both buttons are on. I'll turn her on again. And it's a button here, a thumb wheel, call it.
Yeah.
Forwards and backwards. And what I think is a really nice touch is we have exactly the same thumb wheel on our remote control. So when we're using the remote control on an ACX, if you wanted to lift something remotely at the fastest speed, you start and stop exactly at that fastest speed.
Okay.
If you're moving very heavy loads, it's maybe not the best thing for your anchors or to get your knots untied afterwards. Whereas with an ICX, I can start slow and then build up my speed, and the same when I stop. So if you're going to move heavier loads, that's obviously a lot kinder.
Okay.
It's the same scenario with the ropes. Skylotec are providing approved ropes.
Yep.
So we've got the RO80, the ELR mm-hmm. and PLR ropes.
Yep, okay.
So you need your ELR, specific equipment lifting rope,
yep.
if you're going to move machinery, tools or parts. And again, that's governed by the way the certification has to be done under the machinery directive. So you can use exactly the same ropes. This is 185 kilos. Although it's one person, that's still a really good load.
That's really significant, isn't it, compared to the ACX? Yeah. Yeah, for a smaller device, it's smaller right up there, isn't it?
Yeah, smaller device, but still all the way up to 185. And of course, we can increase it with mechanical advantage, so we could make more.
Yep.
Then that allows us to lift tools and equipment as long as you use the right rope.
Any other features? Yeah. I mean, obviously, I saw the kill switch.
So we've got the kill switch. What I like is, what I think is really good, is I said this has lots more safety features. So if I open one button and just have the gate slightly open, now we can see a red flashing light. It won't work. When I open it completely, if I'm looking to inspect the wheel, even if I've forgotten to use the emergency stop or turn the machine off, it won't run. The wheel's not going to turn, so it eliminates that moving machinery part. I'm not going to get my fingers stuck in there.
Yeah.
So as soon as it's down, the light will go back out, and I'm working again. Emergency stop, it's nice and close by.
Yeah.
So you can just stop anytime you want. So if you're on the ropes and you're parking and you want to lock the machine out so you can't knock anything or do anything, then it's easy to do, just push it.
Okay.
If we're on and we have an issue, we still have an emergency descent. So if my battery goes flat, I lose a battery, whatever reason,
I can, stranded, you can
push that button, control the descent rope, and we slide down.
Brilliant.
Of course, it's exactly the same as we say with the ACX. Do not use the emergency descent as an alternative descent mode.
Yeah.
There's still the potential to overcharge your batteries if you've got a fully charged battery and you're trying to descend by using the emergency descent button.
Okay. So how does that work, sorry, Bob? So does it regenerate through?
Yeah, we have an even more efficient, I mean, it's not 100% efficient, there never ever will be,
right.
but you do charge your battery in descent and you'll see the charging because the green lights will blink at you when the power's going back into the battery.
Oh, right, okay, brilliant.
So,
clever.
On long drops, you regain power and make your battery life last longer. So, again, as we said at the beginning, it depends on exactly what the operations are you're doing. Are you ascending, descending? Are they very long drops, very full descents, or are they just short start-stop jobs? That'll all affect the battery life and how it charges.
Okay, brilliant, fantastic. I think we've pretty much covered most of the basics there, do you think? I mean, I know, obviously, like I said earlier, we do have the more in-depth ACX Masterclass, which takes you into a little bit more detail on the power descended range that Skylotec offer. So if you're happy, Bob, shall we?
If we get on the ropes, we can look at the rope loading. We can use the remote control. We can go up and down and have a look at those other features as well.
Sounds good to me. Cool.
Excellent.
Let's go there. Okay, so in half a second, Bob's miraculously managed to rig up the ICX. He works quick. So, Bob, come on, let's take us through it.
Right, so, dead simple. Pick it up and take it in the left hand.
Okay.
Open. One, two switches. Yep. Rope. Just going to bring it behind that rope guard. That will put it into the rope guide straight away here at the bottom.
Okay.
Over the wheel, round and down. Get the gate. Push it shut.
Yep.
Make sure the rope's in the rope wheel.
Okay.
Both buttons are over. There's a pictogram on the side here on the rope guide in and out. So it shows you exactly which way around the wheel it goes. Then it's already turned on. E stops out. I can just up and down with that button. So if I just take that, clip it into my attachment point.
Yep.
Take our back up.
Okay.
Side for a second. And then away we go. And with that wheel, you've got perfect control of the speed.
So did he say it's the same speed as the ACX?
Yes.
Yes.
Yeah, very approximately.
Right, okay.
I'm not going to guarantee every time exactly the same, because it might be an old battery or something, but
yeah of course.
24 metres a minute.
Right, brilliant.
Same speed.
Right.
And of course, we have our remote control.
Okey-doke.
So we'll turn that on. What we're going to do, see a blue flashing light.
Yeah.
And then there's a blue light on the handle and our light there. When that's gone solid, we've got control.
Yeah.
And because we've got the same thumb wheel, I can control the speed. Yeah, so I can start
really
slowly.
Yeah.
And up, and slow. And down, slow, and just control the speed.
Oh, that's impressive. Yeah.
Nice machine.
Really, really good.
So, what we could look at is the emergency descent feature. So if I just clip in and go up.
Yep.
This is a different size machine and the engineering and everything in it is completely brand new.
Okay.
Basically, we're just going to disengage the brake, the automatic brake,
right,
inside the machine.
Okay.
It will allow the motor and gears to turn.
Yeah.
We'll still want to hold the tail rope to control,
right,
the descent, but there's a little thumb catch so I can put my thumb in and press it.
Okay. Great.
So we'll just go up a couple of feet. And then if I hit the e-stop or took the battery out or whatever, I can put my thumb against there, hold the tail rope, and just control my descent.
That's brilliant. Lovely.
And then, of course, if I turn my e-stop back out,
it's back,
turn the machine on, we're back in, yeah.
Yeah, lovely.
So, there's a couple of other things really to go over. Charge time will depend on the size of the battery, so a bigger battery obviously is going to take longer to charge.
Mm-hmm.
The BLI 200 is about a 90-minute charge, very similar to your ACX.
ACX, yeah.
Gets a bit longer as your other batteries go up. Battery care, obviously read the manual, but it's the same thing. Very cold temperatures won't do it any good. Very hot temperatures won't. The Husqvarna batteries are really top-notch. It actually has its self-cooling system inside it. You can hear it come on when you're charging. So when you're charging it, it can charge a bit quicker because it keeps it cooler. But that's all engineered into the batteries. That's already there.
Okay.
You can store them when they're not fully charged, maybe 30, 40% is okay. You can give them a maintenance charge every so often, 3 months or so if it's not needed. But it's a very advanced battery technology from Husqvarna.
Brilliant. And I know that last time we covered sort of weather conditions as well, use in weather conditions.
So you've got the same
rating. Ingress.
Yeah, we've got an IP55 rating.
Okay.
So it's good for dust and moisture, showers, rain, not submergible. It's not like the RCX, which we could dunk underwater.
Yeah.
This is great for working around. I mean, Husqvarna obviously are selling this into the arborist industry.
Yes.
So they're up there in trees in all sorts of weather. As I would expect this to be out on telecoms riggers, utilities, wind turbines, it'll have loads of applications.
Mm-hmm. Highly versatile still. Yeah.
Really.
Brilliant.
It's so much smaller. It's about half the weight of the ACX.
Mm.
So it's about 6.5 kilos or so, I think it is. Again, different batteries will affect its weight.
It didn't look clunky next to you whilst you were going up and down on the rope.
No,
quite easy to manoeuvre.
We can do exactly we can do exactly the same thing with extending it as well.
Yeah.
So that's very common for the ACX, that people will just extend it up to give them a bigger field of work. It's a lot more cost effective. So the retail price of this, and this is in euros because I work for a German company, so you can tag it in with a UK RRP price.
Yeah, we will.
But we retail in Europe for €6,500.
Okay.
As a kit with one battery, remote control, and all the cables and charging.
It's bang for your buck, really, though, isn't it? I mean, it's, you know, for a couple of projects, you're going to get that money back, aren't you, if you're a rope access team?
The time that you save.
Yeah.
I remember going out and doing a demonstration with some telecoms guys, and even doing the demonstration in half a day we were at the same place they would have been at the end of the day.
Yeah.
So even with messing about and doing all the talking,
yeah,
I could save half a day's labour on rigging a telecoms tower for lifting up equipment.
Yeah, it's...
And this will do exactly the same,
yeah,
but it'll do it for half the price.
Yeah, it's fantastic. Okay, cheers, Bob. Thank you very much for coming down.
That's
again.
My pleasure.
Really enjoyed going through the ICX. And again, don't forget, we do have the previous video of the ACX. Please do like and subscribe through our YouTube channel and do visit our webshop. We'll put a link below somewhere around. And we'll see you for the next one. Thank you.